our students have been studying the interactions between humans, wildlife, and the environment here at Middle Creek for the last 2 months. We've been doing this through things like analyzing trail camera footage, virtual field trips. We've listened to bird audio files and used the Merlin app to help analyze what type of birds are here. We've been able to adopt mallard hens and track their movement and learn about bird banding. Our learners are center-based emotional support students, and they haven't really had a lot of success in the traditional classroom. So giving really cool hands-on experiences is so important for them, but it's also really important to like structure that in a way that supports all of their different needs. So really keeping them engaged and exciting about something, but while still learning.
You know, you give them a chance to blow that duck call and make some noise. They love the interaction of looking at the screen, seeing where their duck is migrating to as it's on the tracking screen, and we're tracking them each week to see where they move about. They feel like they're a part of that duck's migration. Seeing the smiles, the high fives, and the accomplishment that they get to have out of this whole program with that big, big smile and those high fives is my joy of the whole thing.
Everybody has a different learning style, right? Like some people are really good at reading a textbook and they get it down pat. Other people need that hands-on connection to really have a passion and a drive to understand something. And by giving kids an opportunity to get hands-on, to get messy, they have a deeper appreciation and understanding for that wildlife, and it helps us to boost conservation efforts for the future and get kids interacted and excited for what's to come.
We were working STEM, music, and art, so sometimes kids would be like, hey, we talked about this in art class or in music class, and really tying in those different things. Like, for instance, I was a music teacher, but we did a song where we worked on binoculars. It was really fun to be able to integrate science and art and different things like that into the music classroom and to stretch myself as an educator and to learn new songs and new ways of teaching that can excite the kids.
Our kids especially have a lot of diverse, intense needs, and it's really hard to get people to see like the inside workings of just day-to-day operations and how our kids function and all the little things that go into helping them achieve their goals. So anybody who's willing to come in from an outside perspective and just spend time with our kids and get to know them and see all of their strengths and their abilities and all the things that they have to give back to the community, anytime that's a possibility, it's a win-win for everybody involved.
After Mr. Matt came in and talked about bird banding and the students actually got to band a decoy goose, I had students go home and talk about that experience with their parents, and that is something that doesn't always happen. And now parents are sending back information about how students have done things like this in the past or how they like to promote this at home. And they felt excited to then be able to share what they've learned and feel like they're scientists too.